Assalamu alaikum. My name is Sarish Munir. I'm a research coordinator at the Department of Pediatrics and Child Health at Aga Khan University Hospital. The topic of my presentation is laboratory biosafety and biosecurity related education in Pakistan, engaging students through the Socratic method of learning. So this study has been published in the Journal of Biosafety and Biosecurity, and I'm presenting on behalf of all the co-authors. This is my presentation outline. We know that the biosafety and biosecurity are the major issues globally in medical and biomedical laboratories, and most notably in developing countries. To alleviate these concerns, international guidelines on the laboratory biosafety have been developed over the time. Unfortunately, despite established guidelines, the laboratory biosafety remains the most neglected domain in the local scenario, be it diagnostic, research, or educational. Researchers, students, and technicians and pathologists working in these laboratories are continuously being exposed to potential biohazard agents and are at a greater risk of acquiring laboratory-associated infections or LAIs. The initial report of LAIs emerged as early as the start of 20th century, where more than 4,000 LAIs and over 160 deaths between 1930 and 1978 have been reported. Recently, the COVID-19 pandemic has re-emphasized the importance of laboratory biosafety and biosecurity-related protocols globally. Therefore, subject-specific education, relevant training, and capacity building in a laboratory biosafety can play a fundamental role in overcoming these challenges. The rationale of our study is we know that there's a huge gap in knowledge, awareness, and standardized training related to biosafety and biosecurity persists regionally and nationally. The implementation of standardized guidelines in clinical laboratory settings remains relatively low, and the situation is even more worse in educational institute where biosafety is not a part of the regular curriculum. This deficiency of standardized training and knowledge at the academic level could potentially put the students and their immediate environment at the risk of exposure to biohazards agent. Therefore, to enhance maximum compliance towards the laboratory biosafety, students should be continuously involved and trained at all the education and research stages. So in this study, we tried to engage students in the laboratory biosafety related education through employing the Socratic approach of learning due to its usefulness in enhancing the learning ability in participants, followed by knowledge assessment through pre and post test. Now, what is Socratic method? It is a technique of learning whereby students are engaged in a reflective and critical thinking. Through this interactive approach, students are exposed to the systematic and probing questions that intend to activate their thought process and develop the rationale of the concept which is under consideration or study. Therefore, the Socratic method is more learner-centered, giving an opportunity to participate in this classroom discussion actively and grasp comprehensive knowledge of issues or concept. Now the objective, the aim of this study was to engage the student at the university level in laboratory biosafety and biosecurity related education through the Socratic method of learning and to assess an increase in awareness through implementing pre and post test models. We conducted two workshops of 3 hours each at the University of Karachi and Shaheed Zulfikar Ali Bhutto Institute of Sciences Technology in October and December 2019 respectively. Total number of registered students were 318 from multiple life sciences departments from University of Karachi and 39 students from Department of Biosciences at SABIS. Students were first administered a pre-test questionnaire to assess their baseline knowledge, followed by a series of interactive questioning by the facilitator to trigger students' thought process to attain desired knowledge along the way. Finally, the concept related to laboratory biosafety and biosecurity was clarified and post-workshop knowledge assessment was carried. Now, workshop content consisted of four primary controls of biosafety that were engineering, PPE, standard operating protocols, procedures, and administrative control, followed by four primary controls of biosecurity, which were physical, personnel, material, and information. Also, the philosophy of containment, which was the study of theoretical basis of biosafety and application of its principle in laboratory settings, and the components of biorisk management, which were hazard identification, risk assessment, risk management, and risk communication. Alongside these theoretical concepts, the workshop also consists of practical demonstration of beaking method for doffing gloves, that is considered the safest method for removing gloves. For workshop assessment, a subject-specific questionnaire was developed to assess the knowledge. It consisted of two parts. Part 1 consisted of 10 objective type questions, and part 2 consisted of 3 subjective type questions. The maximum possible scores of all 13 questions combined was 22, and same questionnaire was administered before and after the workshop in the form of pre and post-test questionnaire. For workshop evaluation, an end of session feedback in the form of rating was obtained to evaluate students' satisfactory views about the trainer's competency, mode and quality of information, and the general impression of the session. For statistical analysis, we use SPSS version 9. Pre and post training scores were computed and students were graded accordingly. Those students scoring less than 7 were considered as low performer. Those between 18 to 15 were average performers, and those scoring 16 and above were high performers. Paired student t-test was used for comparing pre and post test scores, and p-value of less than 0.05 was considered significant. The difference between the pre and post-test scores were checked for data normality, and percentages were computed for rating from the feedback forms. This figure 1 is showing the total registered student for the workshop. Both the workshop was 357, out of which 90% provided the consent and completed pre and post-test questionnaire, whereas 10% were excluded because of either they failed to give consent or complete the pre or post-test questionnaires. Figures showing you the percentage of undergraduate and postgraduate student, where maximum number of students belong to first year, followed by second and third year students. Now, this is showing you the pre and post test performances of study participants, where you can show that in the pre-test scores, almost 98% students were low performer, whereas in the post test, 87% student scored more than 16 and became high performing students post workshop. This graph is showing you the percentage increase in the awareness among student pre and post workshop training, and you can see that there was a 70% increase in the knowledge after the workshop, and there was from 14% to 18% pre-test and post-test. Similarly, when we computed the percentages of objective and subjective type of questions separately, so there's a substantial increase in the knowledge in the post-test in the objective type of questions, as you can see from the orange bars in the graph. Found in the subjective type of questions, where students were asked to name the four components of four primary controls of biosafety and biosecurity, along with four components of biorisk management, and there was no baseline knowledge, as you can see in the pre-test, but there was a high and substantial increase in the knowledge post-test. This was the result of the paired t-test analysis, and there was the results were statistically significant. Finally, this graph is showing you the students' level of satisfaction, which was related to workshop, its content, and trainer's proficiency. Students were asked to rate the overall training program, the quality of information, and the instructor, and you can see that it was 76, 86, and 93% respectively. So finally, this study was one of its kind at the university level, which predominantly focused on the creating biosafety awareness among students through Socratic learning. Like most Asian countries, the culture of passive learning, rote memorization, and teacher-centered education prevails in Pakistan, resulting in failure to actively engage students in critical thinking process. So that Socratic approach of learning was found to be instrumental for student engagement and knowledge gain. The pre-post-test approach analyzed former knowledge on the topic and also help in triggering those factors that improve the concentration of individual to be more attentive and receptive during. However, our study had some limitations, which was small sample size, time limitation, because all the concept cannot be delivered in the time duration of only 3 hours. And finally, we only assess the knowledge gain and not the impact of education on their journal practices. This would have required an additional or follow-up study, and it would be very interesting to know that whether the education, what impact our education had on the journal practices of those students. For future recommendation, we recommend that the laboratory biosafety should be prioritized and included as a compulsory course in those academic organizations which are teaching life sciences to ensure maximum compliance. In conjunction with theoretical content, relevant hands-on practices should also be integrated into the curriculum. And leadership of the academic organization should take the responsibility for capacity building on the institutional level to address the impending needs concerning laboratory. In conclusion, the study highlighted the significance of relevant education, training, and practical demonstration in augmenting knowledge and understanding pertinent to laboratory biosafety and biosecurity. Considering the current scenario of pandemic, conducting such educational workshop periodically in academic setting should be emphasized to promote and sustain biosafety culture on individual and organization level. Finally, we would like to thank all these people and institute for their help and support for conducting the current study. Here are the references. Thank you so much.